Hello everyone, to myself Ruchi Vasnik. Today's topic of my presentation is evaluating the role of some medicinal plants having antibacterial property as quorum quenchers. Before going into the research work, I would like to introduce the topic by quorum sensing. Quorum sensing is a mechanism of cell-to-cell communication in bacteria. Both gram-negative and gram-positive bacteria has this mechanism, and it is important for generating pathogenicity and to coordinate the virulence factors in the bacteria, and most importantly to escape the immune response from the specific host. And these quorum sensing systems are regulated with the help of autoinducers, which are small molecules. In gram-negative bacteria, an acyl homoserin lactone act as an autoinducer, and generation and storage of this autoinducer is proportional to the increased population of the bacteria. So thereby, more the AHL molecules, more the bacteria will be presented. More the bacteria goes, more the infection. So quorum quenching is a phenomenon which acts by eliminating the bacterial infection by interfering with microbial cell-to-cell communication. So any molecules which are synthetic analogs to AHL could also act as quorum quencher. Plant as quorum quencher is a very novel phenomenon, and there are a few reports which suggest that plant could also act as quorum quenchers. Here in this study, we have studied three plants, namely Azadirachta indica, Solanum virginianum, and Eucornea crescipes. The methanolic plant extracts of these three plants were checked for their antimicrobial effect on two of the gram-negative bacteria, namely Astypimurium and E. coli. And finally, the role of these plant extract on quorum sensing was determined by the level of AHL molecules. So the results here, we can see that in Salmonella and in E. coli, different plant extracts were used. By well diffusion method, we analyzed what is the zone of inhibition, and here in the bar graphs we can see that wild brinjal has shown more zone of inhibition in Salmonella, whereas neem has shown more zone of inhibition in case of E. coli. So these two plant extract could act as antibacterial in these two bacteria. Next, we wanted to know whether these property of antimicrobial property is governed by AHL. So to know that, we have developed colorimetric method in the lab, and the level of AHL is determined by brown coloration at the end. So by using spectrophotometer, we see the optical density of the brown color, and we can observe that a treatment of all the three plant extract has reduced the level of AHL in both the species Salmonella and E. coli. Thereby, all the three plant extracts have ability of reducing AHL level. So in conclusion, we can say that two of the plant extract could act as antibacterial, whereas all the three plant extract have potential to reduce the AHL. Therefore, mechanism behind the antibacterial activity is not limited to quorum quenching in these selected plants. So the future perspective of the work is to check the level of AHL in more accurate form by using GC-MS analysis, and to know whether AHL level is a sole regulator of the antimicrobial activity in these plant extracts. These are the references for this presentation, and thank you so much.